Hey guys, welcome to another algebra lesson. In the previous lesson, you guys learned how to expand. So if you haven't done that, or you're not sure how to do that, then please go back to the previous lesson before you continue with this lesson, which is on factorising, which you need to know how to expand in order to do. So let's do a quick revision on expanding. So we have 5 times 2x, the term at the front, multiplied by each term on the inside. 5 times 2x plus 5 times 3, so 5 times 2x plus 5 times 3, so we have 10x plus 15. Okay, so when you're factorizing is simply factorizing 10x plus 15 is simply taking out the highest common factor, putting it at the front. So 5 bracket 2x plus 3. Factorizing is just the opposite of expanding. So when you expand, you get rid of the brackets, and when you factorize, you put it back into the brackets. So if you write down this as the answer, then you have just factorized it. But how do we know that the number in front is 5? Okay, so what you do is you use a technique called find the highest common factor. Find the highest common factor of the two terms that we want to factorize, 10x and 15. Now you can see that we have 10 and 15, and the highest common factor for both of them is just 5. So a factor means a number that can multiply another number to give us the number that we want. So 5 times 2 is 10, 5 times 3 is 15, so 5 is a number for both 10 and 15. Now notice we don't just have 10, we have 10x. So 5 times 2x is 10x, right? 5 times 3 is 15, so 5 is still a factor for both of these terms. And in fact, it's the highest common factor, because you can't think of a number that is bigger than 5 that will still multiply into both 10x and 15. So therefore, you put 5 at the front of the bracket, and then all you have to do is think in your head, 5 times what will give us 10x? 5 times 2x will give us 10x. And then 5 times what will give us 15? 5 times 3 will give us 15. So 10x plus 15 is factorized into 5 bracket 2x plus 3. Now let's do a couple more examples. Factorize. Number 1. 15x plus 30. Number 2. 16 plus 24x. And number 3, let's make it harder. 20x squared plus 4x. And number 4, let's make it really hard. 30x to the power of 5 plus 20x to the power of 4. Let's make it 3. Okay, so let's do the first one. Now we have 15x and 30. 15 is the highest common factor for both. 15 times 1x. 15 times 1x is 15x. 15 times 2 is 30. So therefore we have just factorized it. Now you don't have to write the arrows in your answer. So you can just rub them out. Okay, now let's do this second one. We got 16 and 24, so 8 is the highest common factor. 8 times 2 is 16, 8 times 3 is 24, 8 times 3x is 24x. The third one, now you notice that we have both x squared and x. So not only are you going to write 4 in the front, but you're going to also write x at the front, because x is a factor for both x and x squared. So 4x times 5x is 4x times 5x is 20x squared, and 4x times 1 is 4x. And the last one, we have 30x to the power of 5 plus 20x to the power of 3. Now notice 10 is the highest common factor for 20 and 30, and x cubed is actually the factor for both x cubed and x to the power of 5. So 10x cubed times 3x to the power of 2 is 30x to the power of 5. And 10x cubed times 2 is 20x cubed. So notice how we have x to the power of 5 and x to the power of 3. And out of the two powers, 5 and 3, we chose the smaller number, x to the power of 3, in our highest common factor. And that is because if we wrote 5 at the front here, if this number was 5, then 5 times 3, so we would cross that out, 10x to the power of 5 times 3 would be 30x to the power of 5. 10x to the power of 5 times, it'll be simply become too complicated for us to write something here to give us x to the power of 3. It'll be 2 over x to the power of 2 or something ridiculous. So to keep it simple, we're just going to have the smaller power at the front where the highest common factor is. So 10x cubed times 3x squared is 30x to the power of 5. 10x cubed times 2 is 20x to the power of 3. Now we're just going to do one more example where you were not able to factorize it fully. So what if we had, for example, 40x to the power of 2 plus 20x equals? And let's say you didn't realize that 20 is the highest common factor and you put 10. And then you didn't realize x is the highest common factor as well, so you just put 10 bracket 4x squared plus 2x. Okay, now this is correct because 10 times 4x squared is 40x squared. 10 times 2x is 20x. But it's also not factorized fully because inside the bracket we can factorize it further. So you need to keep going until the two terms inside the bracket have no more common factors. So 10 times, so sorry, let's have a look at the 4x squared and the 2x. We can take out 2x as the highest common factor. So therefore, 2x times 2x is 4x squared. And so 2x times 2x is 4x squared. 2x times 1 is 2x. Okay, now that the terms inside the bracket, 2x and 1, have no more common factors, we can now get rid of this bracket on the outside. So that simply means 10 times 2x bracket 2x plus 1. So 10 times 2x is 20x bracket 2x plus 1. So it's taken us a few more steps to do. It'll simply be faster if you can see that between 20 and 40, 20 is the highest common factor. And if you put that in the beginning, it'll take you a lot less steps to do than having to factorize it continuously until you get it down to the simplest terms. Okay, thanks for watching the factorization tutorial. See you next time.